And are you sick of talking about something wild after all of this?
No, not talking about something wild.
Were you a were you a child writer at the time? Or were you like 25 years old or something?
That was a spec, right? I mean, just like,
yeah, you know, I was in film school and I wrote that in film school and got out and you know, flew to LA and tried to get an agent, which I did fairly rapidly. And yeah, he said, "Who would you like to see direct this?" And I said, "Martin Scorsese or Jonathan Demme?" And Scorsese was directing After Hours, and they sent it to Demme, and the lowest person on the food chain in Demme's office happened to be Ed Saxon, who had just graduated from the Peter Stark School. And so he read it over the 4th of July weekend and gave it to Jonathan, and Jonathan said, "Hey, I want to make this." And so you got thought, made. And
yeah,
I thought,
this is how it happens.
Yeah, I did. Oh, sure, okay. Yeah. Yeah. Good, okay.
And things changed a little bit after this movie? The experience of being a screenwriter in the business?
Something Wild?
Yeah, after Something Wild, was it a little different on the next movie?
Oh, well, of course. I mean, then reality struck, and you realize how much you got to go through to get these made, and just the serendipity needed to get them produced.
Did you work closely with Demme on the picture?
Yeah, I would say so. I remember I did all the casting to try to find the Ray Liotta character with him. We flew to L.A., we were in New York, trashed the offices at Orion, you know, people coming in and putting their hands through the walls and kicking holes in the desk and everything. And I remember being in some cheesy motel on Sunset when Ray Liotta came in to read with Jeff Daniels, and it was just like, whoa. I went, oh, that dude, man. Yeah, it was just sparks flying. I think Jeff Daniels was terrified the first time he came in and read. Woo! Yeah, so.
Well, actually, I often tell the story about actually in 84th Street in New York, going to that multiplex that is there, I guess still it's there.
Yeah.
And how kids would go from one theater to the other and, you know, see all kinds of things. And it didn't really bother me when kids would come in and, you know, see nudity or whatever. But the last 10 minutes of Something Wild bothered me. Kids, like, I heard, like, 10-year-olds or whatever, 12-year-olds behind me at the screening, and I'd seen the movie before, second time I'd seen the movie. And I was like, to me, this was, like, something that children should not see. It was the most violent thing I think I'd ever seen on screen. At that time, the sequence in the house at the end.
Yeah.
Just seemed to me like the most, somehow most profoundly violent, and physically it's not, obviously, it's not bloody so much, but it just seemed like the most profoundly intimate kind of violence I'd ever experienced in the theater.
You know, I think sorry.
No, hey,
you
that's
can
flip good.
Through this if you'd like.
We're talking about his movies in a minute.
Yeah. I think that, I don't know that Jonathan knew that he could direct that kind of violence. Nothing that I had seen, and I really loved Melvin and Howard. That was the one thing, and the Talking Heads documentary thing. It was those two things. I thought, oh well, you can do that, and then you can do that. I bet you'd be good for my movie. But I don't think that he had really filmed violence the way that he did in Something Wild. And I think there's always the talk of that I've heard over the years of, oh, it was started this tone and then it changed and it became this thing in the dark. Part of that obviously was the acting with Ray, but part of it I thought was the proficiency that Jonathan showed and how to shoot violence, that came out later in Silence of the Lambs that just had everybody terrified. So I don't know that he had done that before.
No.
So.
And that tone was that tone was all over the place, but in a way that was real. I mean, it's one of my favorite movies.
Oh, well,
you know.
Thank you.
Now you feel the love.
Now I feel the
now
love.
Now you feel better.
Yeah.
And we love you too, Dan.
Thank you.
Well, you talked about Capote enough, so.
That's right. We had our little Capote chat.
Yeah.
Damn it.
Yeah.
So